Bio digester construction using blocks is what this video is about. Traditional bio digester construction has a family large size and the newly designed soakaway that we have introduced for our bio digester constructions is basically what we are doing at this 3-bedroom house with 4 toilets right here in Accra. We usually prefer the quarried out blocks because then with water being in the ground and water coming into the digester, you want blocks that have been firmly pressed that will last for a longer time. The idea of biodigesters and biodegradable toilets with biodigesters simply means that you are trying to treat the human waste through biodegradation process. A fast difference to the traditional means of managing human waste that we have come to know over the years. This newly designed soakaway that I'm introducing in my biodigester construction, the good thing for us and for you is that these soakaways are easily accessible and it's just not being done like the normal soakaway pit where we put stones in the ground and then we just cover it with a layer of black polythene rubber and then we cover it with the topsoil. But rather we are trying to secure the ground and make sure that there's always a space for the water to go. If there's an issue, you can come and lift the slab on this soakaway and then have a look in there and see where the problem might be. Or simply have a look at the digester itself and know that, okay, the soakaway that we have constructed for this digester is something we can easily have access to. That's why we do soakaways like this. So we do have the inlet pipe. The idea of the inlet pipe is also to make sure that you check all the toilet seats that are in the house that are coming into the digester and then placing the inlet pipe at an angle or at a slope and level that makes sure that all the pipes will come and there's not going to be any problem in the near future. You need a good gradient for your inlet pipe so that nothing gets stuck in the bio digester. With this construction, what we are doing is that we are going to use the porous slab. The porous slab has been done for filtration and the understanding of the porous slab is that wastewater will seep through and then it will filter the water before it goes into the soakaway. So what we are doing is just to make sure we do the ground, do the screening and then just place the porous slab on it and then we are good to do it. So the porous slab is being placed on the bio digester bed. This is how the screeding has been done. And then the blocks have been used to cover all around the inside of the bio digester bed. All we need is to have an outlet for the wastewater to go with the sloping that will take it out of the bio digester bed. Make sure the coconut fiber is evenly spread on the digester bed, covering all areas of it. The fiber net or the mosquito net must be the first thing to go on it. The idea of the fiber net or mosquito net is to make it easy to remove the biodegradable material in the future when you need to do maintenance. When you come and just leave the net and then you lay another one. So this is the biodigester bed preparation, including the coconut fiber, just on it. People ask about the bioenzymes that must also go into a biodigester. Everything is done well. You do not need a bioenzyme. All you need is a coconut fiber, which has been treated to do the work for you when it comes to biodigester construction. So make sure your gradient is right. Make sure your slope is right. Make sure your soakaway has got an outlet for the water to go out of the digester, which is your biggest problem. And then make sure your biodegradation materials are also on point when you construct a biodigester. And then you are good to go. This is a channel dedicated to construction of biodigesters and human waste solution providers in Ghana, in Dreamhouse Biodigesters. The video that will be showing this on this channel will explain to you how to construct a biodigester to how to use it as a means of managing human waste in your own property.